हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम जय पटेल। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू 10th स्टैंडर्ड फिजिक्स। सो बिफोर आई विल स्टार्ट माय टीचिंग, आई विल गिव इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट ई बुक, वीडियो, वर्कशीट, आंसर की ऑफ वर्कशीट, होमवर्क, टेस्ट एंड रिजल्ट कंडक्टेड बाय अवर स्कूल। So students, when you click on this link, so at that time our SVV study material web page will open. So when you go downwards, scroll down, so these all the classes list and all the subject web page will appear. In that one, 10th standard students click on science subject. So at that time, these three box will appear. Science three folders will come: biology, chemistry, and physics. When you click on physics, you can see that these are three different folders. Means SI, first one is ebook, second one is assignment, and third one is all the videos will be appear. From ebook, you can download our textbook. From assignment folder, you can download the worksheet, and you can see these videos which all the physics teacher, or I can say science teacher, have uploaded. Now when you scroll down, at that time this SVV test series will come. So school will take a test every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So you will click on class 10 test. At that time, this announcement folder will come. In every Monday, there will be announcement of test. It means test timetable will be given. So you have to appear the test every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. You can see in the next three video, this one, blue color links are there. So when you click that particular link, your tests will start. And when you scroll down, so at that time this result page will come. Every Thursday, most probably on every Thursday, you can see your test result. So when you click on that one, you can see that one. This is the result link. When you click on this particular result link, your marks will come. So this way, you can give the test, you can download ebooks and all that things. I request to all the students that they will see the video as well as they can start giving the particular test. Now in this video, I am going to teach you lesson number 13, magnetic effects of electric current. So let's learn about that thing. Students, the magnetic effects of electric current is known as electromagnetic effect. It is observed that when the compass is brought near a current carrying conductor, the needle of compass gets deflected because of flow of electricity. This shows that electric current produces a magnetic effect. It means that when compass you brought near a current carrying conductor, it means that from the wire, if the electricity is passed and you take this compass nearby that one, so compass needle got deflected. This was first observed by the scientist named Hans Christian Oersted. So this is his observation. So it is also asked in the exam, write the Hans Christian Oersted observation. So you write down this one, and this is the photo of Hans Christian Oersted. Hans Christian Oersted, one of the leading scientists of the 19th century, played a crucial role in understanding electromagnetism. In 1820, he accidentally discovered that compass needle got deflected when electric current passed through a metallic wire placed nearby. It means that compass needle got deflected when electricity passed from the wire and its compass is nearby that particular wire. Through this observation, Oersted showed that electricity and magnetism were related phenomena. His research later created technologies such as radio, television and fiber optics. So after invented this thing, it is very easy to make radio, television and other instruments. Okay students, let's learn the new topic. First one is magnetic field and field lines. So what is magnetic field? So the region around a magnet where the force of attraction or repulsion can be detected is called magnetic field. Magnetic field around a magnet can be detected by using a magnetic compass. So let's understand this activity. So you take a bar magnet, you fix like this way on the white paper or cardboard, and you take the compass nearby it. So you can see that one from right side north pole. Take the first compass. So near the north pole, all the south pole compass needle will attract. We know that from the magnet, north pole will attract the south pole. It means that north and south pole will attract and north pole will repel each other. Or we can say that south and south pole will repel each other. When you move this magnet towards the south pole, this direction of the compass is different. Now you can see it here near the south pole, red color needle should be attracted by the south pole. So it compass needle get deflected when you rotate this compass near by this magnet. You can see that near the north pole, white color magnet needle should be attracted by the north pole, and near south it should be red one. So near the magnet there should be a force of attraction or repulsion can be detected, that is called the magnetic field. Now this is the magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines are the path around the magnet along which the north pole of magnetic compass needle tends to move. The magnetic field lines around a magnet can be observed by the sprinkling iron fillings around a magnet. It can also be observed by moving a magnetic compass around a magnet. It means that our earlier activity, we have rotated the compass nearby the magnet, so we can see the magnetic field lines. When you joined this all these point, it create the magnetic field lines. Now first point, the magnetic field lines emerge at the north pole and merge at the south pole. So you can see it here, second diagram, north pole, the magnetic field lines is coming out and it merge or join again or goes into the south pole. The magnetic field lines are closer at the poles. You can see that one nearby the in second figure, near the north and south one, magnetic field lines are very close to each other. And the third point, magnetic field lines do not intersect each other. So these all magnetic field lines are nearby each other, but they are not intersect with each other. For understanding these magnetic field lines, we have to do one activity. We have to take one magnet. Then above this magnet, I am explaining this first diagram. We have to take the magnet. Above that one, we have to keep one cardboard or page and we have to sprinkle the iron. Then on that particular cardboard, we can see that these type of patterns. So these are all magnetic field lines. Okay. Then students, we are going to learn three different activities. In that one, which type of pattern will generate it? So the first one, this is our topic, magnetic field due to current carrying conductor. So it means that which type of magnetic field can be generated or produced near at these three different particular things. The first one, magnetic field due to the current through a straight conductor. It means that when we'll take a straight wire and we will pass the electricity and we'll sprinkle the iron filings, which type of magnetic field or what type of pattern generated nearby that straight conductor. Second one, magnetic field due to the current through the circular loop. It means that we have to take conductor and same wire in the first activity, when we form into the circular way, so near this circular wire, which type of magnetic field generated or which type of pattern will be generated. And third activity, magnetic field due to the current in solenoid. So near the solenoid or inside the solenoid, which type of magnetic field or which type of pattern will be generated. So these three activities we are going to learn. In short, we will learn here that which type of pattern will be generated nearby this three activity. It should be straight, it should be circular, it should be triangle, it should be rectangle, like this way. Okay, before going to this activity, one concept should be there. It should be says right hand thumb rule. So we have to use this concept in all these three activities. So first understand what is right hand thumb rule. So the direction of the magnetic field around a conductor is given by the right hand thumb rule. So direction of magnetic field, in which direction it should be moving, it should be given by the right hand thumb rule. What is the rule? It states that if a current carrying conductor is held in the right hand such that thumb points in the direction of the current, then the fingers wrapped around the conductor shows the direction of the magnetic field. It is very easy that first you hold a straight conductor in your right hand like shows in this particular figure, and the thumb points the direction of the current. It means that you can see that one, the thumb is going upward direction. So here the direction of current should be upwards, and the fingers wrapped around. It means that you can see that fingers are wrapped around. It means it is moving anti-clockwise. Here you can see that circles are moving. It is for moving anti-clockwise. So from this right hand rule, we can understand two things: direction of current and direction of the magnetic field. So if thumbs take the upward in north direction, suppose, so the direction of the magnetic field is anti-clockwise, and we will inverse doing like this way. It means that we can keep our thumb downward direction. Let's take example, it's a south direction, opposite direction. So then magnetic field should be moving in circular path. Here also in circular path, but in downward direction, when thumbs indicate downward direction, so it should be moving, current moving downward direction and circle so moving clockwise direction. It means that we can say that the magnetic field will move in clockwise direction. I hope you understand this right hand thumb rule. Then let's start the first activity, magnetic field due to the current carrying conductor. So if the magnetic compass is placed near a conductor carrying current, the needle is deflected. This shows that conductor carrying current has magnetic field around it. If the direction of the current is from north to south, the deflection of the magnetic needle is towards the east. You can see it first figure downwards. If it is moving north to south one, the compass needle should be deflected east side. If current moves from north to south, the deflection of magnetic needle is east side. If the direction of the current is from south to north, second diagram, the deflection of the needle is towards the west side. The compass needle should deflect west side. If we reverse the direction of the battery, positive to negative or negative to positive, then the magnetic field around the current carrying straight conductor is in the concentric circles. It can be observed by passing a current carrying straight conductor through the cardboard and sprinkling iron filling on it. Now students, we have to take cardboard for this activity. We have to pass this straight wire connected to battery, switch and all that things, and we have to sprinkle the iron fillings. When we switch on the battery, at that time all these iron fillings will showing this type of pattern, circular patterns. So you understand here circular patterns are forming. Now in which direction the current is moving and which direction magnetic fields are moving, that is applied here right hand thumb rule. You can see the arrows are draw on that particular circle. Why it should be drawn in that particular line this way, same way? Why it is not in opposite way? So because we have to apply the right hand thumb rule. Here you can see that one on wire, red color arrows are there. So current is moving from downwards to upwards. It means that from upward direction, so it indicates, you mention it with your right hand thumb rule like this way. Current is in upward direction and this web of the finger, these fingers are moving in circular path. So these are forming anti-clockwise. You can see this one. When you do the circle like this way, all the fingers, so these are moving in anti-clockwise. And if the direction of the current is downward direction like this way, then wrap of the finger, when you are joining like this way, it is all are forming circular path. It means that it should be moving in circle way if the direction of the current in downward direction. But here the current is moving, direction of current in upward side, so we can apply the right hand thumb rule in upward direction. And circles are forming, you close all your fingers like this way, so it is closing anti-clockwise like this way. So this way we can find the direction of the magnetic fields. Here direction of the magnetic field is anti-clockwise. Okay, then understand this concept. It is similar. A current carrying straight conductor has magnetic field in form of concentric circles. Already I told that here when straight wire we have to take or straight conductor we have to take, so at that time circles are formed. Magnetic field of current carrying straight conductor can be shown by the magnetic field lines. So these all are forming magnetic field lines. The direction of magnetic field through a current carrying conductor depends upon the direction of flow of electric current. The direction of magnetic field gets reversed in case of change in the direction of the electric current. It means that if we change the terminals of the battery, first we have connected positive to negative, and if we reverse the direction of the current, then it should be move inverse way. Okay, so from activity number one, concentric circles are formed in straight conductor wire when we will take straight conductor. Now this is our second activity, magnetic field due to the current through the circular loop. Suppose we have straight wire, a long straight wire. When we are fold it and you have to make it like circular path like this way, and we have to take the cardboard. So from cardboard it passes through the two different holes. So here when we pass the electricity and we will sprinkle the irons, so this one its circular loop will forming two different patterns. You can see that one, two different circles, and here in center it should pass straight magnetic field lines. So understand this one, when current is passed through the circular loop, the magnetic field produced in the form of concentric circles around the conductor. Toward the center, arcs of the circles become larger and appears as a straight line. It means here, at the center, a straight magnetic field line can pass, and left hand side and right hand side, two different concentric circles will appear when we will sprinkle the iron fillings on the cardboard, and then after we will pass electricity through it. And we have to find the direction of the current with applying the right hand thumb rule. Okay, students. Then our third activity, but before that one, you should know about the solenoid. So what is meaning of solenoid? So you can see it here in diagram, a large number of circular turns. So this just above figure, not connected to the battery. So that large number of circular turns, that is called the solenoid, which is a shape of cylinder. So that is called the solenoid. It means straight wire. Suppose you have straight wire in your hand, you have to convert them into large circular turns. And when it forms the cylinder type structure, that is called the solenoid. And both the end of the solenoid can connect it to the batteries, plug key, and all other apparatus. So definition of solenoid, a solenoid is the circular coil of the wire in the shape of the cylinder. So this structure is known as the solenoid. So now near the solenoid, which type of the magnetic field will generate? So magnetic field due to the current in a solenoid or nearby the solenoid, when current flows through a solenoid, it behaves like a magnet. It means we have to connect like that and connect it to the battery. When we switch on, so this solenoid is behave like a magnet. The ends of the solenoid behaves like the north and the south poles of the magnet. It means that this solenoid will become magnet, and one end it should be become north pole and second end should be become the south pole. The magnetic field produced by the solenoid is similar to the magnetic field produced by the magnet. So that we have learned already. First activity, we have to take magnet, keep cardboard on it, and we have to sprinkle that one iron fillings, and whichever type of magnetic field already shows in this third number diagram, you can see it in here. So same type of magnetic field can be generated by the solenoid. The strength of the magnetic field depends upon the strength of the current and the number of turns of the coil. If we will give the large voltage or more voltage connected to the large voltage battery, or we can give the more voltage, it should be strong magnetic field can be generated. And it also depends on the turns. If more turns, more magnetic field, less turns, less magnetic field will be generated in the solenoid. So students, we have learned three activities. In first activity, straight copper wire or straight conductor, near the straight conductor, concentric circles are formed. Second activity, circular loop, in that one two different types of circulars are formed, and in straight it should be pass a straight magnetic field line. And in the solenoid, its magnetic field lines are SM as the magnets, or we can say the bar magnet. Okay, I hope you understand. Now, students, you write this question and answer in your physics notebook. So these are the few questions. First question is, define magnetic fields. Second, straight right hand thumb rule. Third, define solenoid. Fourth, draw a diagram for magnetic field lines near by the bar magnet. Fifth, list which type of magnetic field lines generate near straight conductor. List which type of magnetic field lines generate near a straight conductor. So I hope you write all the answers in physics notebook. Thank you very much.